So welcome again, Pharmacircuit, Pharma friends, and I am extremely pleased and happy to welcome my long-term, you know, senior friend and philosopher and guide in the industry, Mr. Bedadyuti Chakraborty. I know him for so many years that if I tell you that you will think that I am 80 plus years old. But still, I know him from my college days. You know, it has been an extreme pleasure to have career counseling from him, you know, when I started, and I was actually studying, you know, microbiology in Aurangabad. And then, you know, of course, Bedada was that time, you know, working at Wockhardt, and you know, he was, you know, he was doing a lot of interesting things, and we all got inspired from him. So he has established now his own consulting company, RxCella, which is a leading academy for pharma and biopharma domain. So he is a counselor, you know, he's doing his own you know, career counseling, mentoring. So you should all participate in RxCella. He has 24 years plus experience in R&D, production, quality, learning. And he has also supported anti-cancer drug development program. Of course, you know, as I said earlier, he started, you know, with R&D and then shifted to quality assurance, where he worked for development quality assurance, clinical quality assurance, process assurance, and also, you know, the most important part, QMS, quality management system, and product release functions. He used to lead the capability building stream and technical training functions of biologics at Dr. Reddy's, you know, where I was also working in, of course, different division. And later he worked for Center of Excellence in the central, you know, learning and development of Dr. Reddy's. And his main motto was to really spread knowledge and excellence. He has authored numerous books. And he also was part of the team when Dr. Reddy's launched first rituximab, you know, the first biosimilar, you know, for treating the blood cancer. And that's how, you know, he's quite well renowned in India because he was part of that, you know, launch. And he also have his first book, Biotechnology, which was honored by Government of West Bengal, India, as the best science book. So he's also an, you know, established author. And of course, he does a lot of, you know, astrology programs with kids. He's a great quiz master, you know, he does a lot of things. You can hear from him for next 30 minutes. I don't need to tell much, but I am really lucky, grateful and privileged to have welcomed him. And he loves to go to college and universities and interact with students to fill the gaps between academics and, you know, the industry practices. So welcome to you, Beda. It's an extreme privilege to welcome you on Pharmacircuit, and the stage is all yours.
Thank you, Kuntal. Thank you so much. And a very good afternoon from India. The time, Indian standard time, if I can quote, it is 2:23 p.m. I know in Germany now it will be a morning. That's why I'm also conveying a very good morning to all the audience, okay, spread across the world. So I am currently situated at Hyderabad. It's a place in India. It's really exactly around middle part of India, a fantastic historic city. I am sitting here, and sitting here only, I am feeling very fortunate to communicate with you. Kuntal, thank you so much, Mario. Thank you so much, Mohua. Thank you so much for giving me such opportunity to engage with you all. With a topic which is very, very core to my heart, how we can bridge really the academia and industry, academics knowledge and industry, the deliverables, how we can manage these two together. I want to share my thoughts with you, especially I want to thrust really for the newcomers, freshers, because every industry nowadays is demanding, they need an experienced people. But how suddenly one student cannot get any experience unless industry is providing that. So I want to share my thoughts, my experience around that and my recent venture, because last just 2 months back, I left my job. 24 years, my job was very, very secured. Somehow I left it. I thought I must work into that direction where I can try in my humble way, whatever experience I have gathered, how I can bridge between academia and industry. There is a gap for sure. Okay. So how we can minimize this gap so that transition whenever a student or researcher will be coming out from academic institute, and when they will be absorbed by pharma industry, there must not be a big struggle at all. It must be a smooth transition. How we can realize it, I want to share my thoughts with you. With your permission, I am projecting my PPT, but I will be moving very fast with the PPT. So let me share my screen. Hope my screen is visible. So this is the logo of for our Ajeta Pharma. And this is my topic today, Pharma and Biopharma, bridging academia and industry for making new generation. Okay. Complete motivation really is there when we talk that making new generation. Because if we are dreaming to make maybe dozen of new molecules in coming 10 years, new generation may play a very, very vital role in developing those molecules or making a very, very quality product for the benefit of mankind. And I told that I am from a historic city of India. The name of this city is Hyderabad. This is 400 years old city, and I am showing one monument at Hyderabad. It is a 400 years old monument. This monument is called Charminar, and excellent history is there in building Charminar. There was a king of this region 400 years back. Name of the king was Quli Qutub Shah. At that time, 400 years back, the dangerous plague disease attacked that city, this city. Plague really ruined the city. Thousands of people died, but at one point of time, plague went off naturally from the city. No vaccine, no antibiotics. 400 years back, plague went off naturally. And with immense joy, people of Hyderabad contributed. And King also contributed. And all of this contribution together made this wonderful monument that is called Charminar. This is the really situated in the heart of the city, and we know this in the name of Charminar. And Hyderabad, when I'm talking, it is a historic city. It is the city of science also, because we know Nobel Prize was initiated in the year of 1901, and second Nobel Prize, 1902, in physiology or medicine, was won by Dr. Ronald Ross. And Dr. Ronald Ross discovered how malaria transmits from mosquito to human. And he did his historic experiment in 1897, I will tell 125 years back, in this city only, which fetched him the Nobel Prize. This particular experiment actually helped him a lot to fetch the Nobel Prize in 1902. Still, that building is there where Dr. Ronald Ross did his experiment on malaria transmission. And I'm very, very proud to tell that few days back, World Health Organization approved Bharat Biotech, one of the pioneer biotech company at Hyderabad. Bharat Biotech's co-vaccine, this is a COVID-19 vaccine, World Health Organization approved few days back, and it is jointly developed by Bharat Biotech industry and National Institute of Virology. It is situated also in India, Pune. So again, industry and academia collaboration has given birth of this fantastic vaccine, which was approved by World Health Organization a few days back. And when I'm talking about India, co-vaccine, two institute and two, one academia and one industry, let me talk about something international. We know that Oxford University and AstraZeneca, one of the big vaccine in this world, which was approved in maximum countries in the in this world till now, 125 countries nearly. And in India, the name of this vaccine is Covishield. That was also the product from academia and industry collaboration. Oxford University and AstraZeneca, they come together, they collaborated together and give the birth of this wonderful vaccine, which is already approved in nearly 125 countries in the world. Academia and industry collaboration. And I want to cite third example of successful academia and industry collaboration. In 1998, U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved Herceptin. Herceptin is a wonderful breast cancer therapy. U.S. FDA approved this product in 1998. And this breast cancer therapy or monoclonal antibody, trastuzumab, is the collaborative effort. It's the outcome of the collaborative effort jointly between University of California, Los Angeles, we call USLA, and the Genentech, the first recombinant biotherapeutics company in this world, which was taken birth in 1976. So Genentech and USLA, industry and academia, they collaborated together to develop this medicine for the breast cancer, trastuzumab. And I have shown a picture of a movie also, Living Proof. And this Living Proof movie was based on this Herceptin development. And the USLA professor, who really masterminded this program, he only took the initiative for the collaboration. It is based on his life and the molecule trastuzumab, what I am talking for at this moment of time. So this is also a successful example of academia and industry. So we cannot avoid industry, we cannot avoid academia for the successful development of drugs. And global pharma industry, if we can see, I tried a lot and I put it in a very, very simple way. With minimum words, global pharma market at this point is $1.2 trillion. Okay, that's the global pharma market in 2020. And it is growing rapidly. In last 20 years, it has increased 4 times. And the prediction is, again, maybe another 5 years, it will touch $2 trillion. The projection is like that. So pharma industry is really growing like anything. And to be very honest, I understand that during COVID days, when a lot of recession happened throughout the world, nothing has happened to pharma and biopharma industry. I can tell that growth started increasing than before. So pharma industry is growing very, very rapidly. And pharma industry is nothing but a combination of many things. Okay, suppose it requires machine, it requires manufacturing facility, it requires method, production method, many things it requires. But most important for the pharma industry, still robot cannot replace 100%. That's the human capital. That is very much required in pharma industry. The human intervention is massive in pharma industry. Though IT application has come, but human intervention is really, it is not replaced at all. We cannot think at this point of time human can be replaced by machine. No, it is not really possible at this point of time, pharma and biopharma industry. But the scale up, the way the scale up is happening, the major challenge is we need expert hands to really cope up the demand of medicine, which really comes from, I will tell, 800 crores population of the world. They need the very good medicines, right? The complexity of diseases are being increased. New medicines are being approved. We need a lot of expert hands for the research and development, for the production, for the manufacturing of pharma products. So one of the major challenges in the pharma industry at this point is getting trusted hands. And if we can get those trusted hands from the freshers, coming freshly from academics, coming freshly from institute, nothing good like that, okay? But the real picture is that maximum pharma companies in this world, really, they are looking for some expertise, okay, some expert hands. But really, probably maximum academics output is not matching the way industry is asking the talent. So here is the gap. Okay, so maybe the industry requirement is not matching exactly with the academics output. So the gap is there for various reasons. So but how we can bridge the gap, that's the conversation I want to share with you, and I will be also needing your opinion. You can write your opinion in the chat box, so that in combined definitely we can crack this issue, and slowly we have to bring the change, and it must happen in one day. Maybe in different countries in this world already a few systems are established, I understand, to bridge this gap, and but major parts of this world I don't feel this gap is really fulfilled. No, it is still existing in a major way. And in pharma and biopharma industries, when we are talking, the people are coming from a diverse background. Okay, we need the people from law and administration. We need the people from IT. We need the people from pharma core background. We need the people from chemistry, biology, management, engineering. In different branches, doctors, we need the people to serve the pharma industry. Pharma industry is not really a carbon and oxygen equal to carbon dioxide. No, we need machines there. We need chemical engineer there. We need mechanical engineer there. We need the automation, IT people there to really fight for the patents and regulatory affairs. We need law people there. Doctors also will be needing to manage the clinical trials. So it's a diverse background, multidisciplinary subject where different people are coming and working together for the development of molecules. This is the pharma industry. And whenever I am talking about the solution, how the industry and academics gap can be bridged successfully. So it is the problem statement is this, that pharma industries are expecting capable people, trusted hands. So if we can build the capability within freshers, and freshers, I am meaning engineering graduates, medical graduates, pharma graduates, and also the PhDs, they are also coming in heavy way in pharma industries. So if we can build the capability of the freshers in the right way, so obviously they will be treated industry ready in a much more positive sense. So we need to build the capability of the freshers. So how we can build the capability? So whatever my experience is last 24 plus years, so it has emerged in my mind that capability is nothing but it is a combination of two things: skill and will. Skill and will together, in combination, we can tell the capability of the people. And what is skill and what is will? Let me explain the way I can really understand these two terminologies. Skill is nothing. It is not only the hands-on part of it. Okay, I want to make the tablet. I know how to handle the tablet manufacturing machine. Definitely, it is the maximum part of the skill. But knowing the bigger picture, so if my machine handling skill is not combined with the bigger picture, because if I want to play football, I know I want to know the playground first of all. Okay, so 11 people are there in my team, 11 people will be in the opponent. This is my ground, this is the goalpost, and what is the target for what I am playing, the final purpose. So bigger picture is very, very important, and the position I am playing, I must be master in that. Okay, maybe machine or analysis, I must be master in that. And so skill is the combination of basically how I am knowing my field, bigger picture, the concept, scientific concepts I am having, how I am and I knowing all the why aspect, what I'm doing, and also the hands-on part of it. We call hands-on part sometime on the job training. So this is skill is the combination of all the things. And what is will? Will is the person within me, okay, my positivity, my analyzing power, okay, my ability to mix with other people, so that we all can deliver as per the what is the purpose, making the quality medicine. That's the purpose, okay. And my internal behavioral expositions, how those are supporting in the final purpose, that is actually will. So capability is two things. One is skill, one is will. And industry really wants a excellent combination or blend within these two in a person. With all these dreams, I really left my job 2 months back. And with the dream, I formed my own organization. I named it as RxLA. Cell means animal cell. We know Rx is medicine. A lot of things are there. And I give the tagline, tell me why. Because knowing why is important in our life. If we can question always in pharma process or in our life. So why question will be leading us real knowledgeable, and we can implement our knowledge. Application part of it will be very, very strong. So this is my organization. And I thought, I really mapped 200 technical concepts which are already existing in pharma industry, not much taught in academic institute. So, but these 200 technical concepts are really talked, I will tell, 80 to 90% of the time in pharma industry. So if we can keep those 200 concepts in a proper flow, that will be probably a very good base for any freshers to start in pharma industry. Already that freshers will be having that base. So 483 deviation, BPR, SOP, CAPA, product release, ICH, validation, FIFO, spec. There I mapped really 200 technical concepts. And these 200 technical concepts, this is the bigger picture. So suppose if I am working in quality assurance or quality control or production or animal toxicity, we must know what is the bigger picture. This is the bigger picture from product selection to patient, how a product is moving from beginning to end. So this is the bigger picture. So whenever we are having the average understanding about the bigger picture, what is happening where, so probably then I will be feeling interest. Okay, yes, I am handling one machine, but my input is coming from this place, and finally my output will be crossing this hurdle and will be reaching to patient. Okay, patient is waiting for me. So this motivation is very, very important. So knowing the bigger picture and knowing the specific role where one person will be mastered, both the things are very, very important for a freshers to build their capability. And I want to talk a little bit about will part of it. In my whatever I mapped 50 behavioral competency tips, priority, 80-20 principle. And CV is very, very important for one freshers, how one CV is being made. CV is going first, not the candidate. So CV is very, very important. And whenever any freshers is there, we don't put much thought to making a really very, very impactful CV or biodata. So what is our original strength? Values are very, very important. Learning pyramid, how we can retain our learning, how we can manage the stress, play with the stress. What is the final purpose? How we can manage the time, how we can behave with the leadership, and how I can be a very good follower as well as I can be a very good leader. Everything are important as a person whenever I will be joining industry, so that it is not the machine, it is the human part of it. Okay, so industry deals with machine, industry deals with man. So behavioral exposition is very, very important whenever we are making any medicine within one industry setup. So this all can be really clubbed or named as a finishing school's concept. And this PFT model is now very, very popular. PFT model, one first P is the push part of it. So academic institute also must be having their curriculum solid, their alumni network. So we need to invite the alumni. Please enlighten the students. Industry lecture is also possible. In that way, academic institute must push the students towards industry. And in between, if we can make one finishing school concept, okay, workshop, 3 days, 4 days workshop, whatever I have told, skill part and will part, that also we can inject within those freshers or newcomers. And pharma industries also must be flexible to tech freshers, little accommodative, okay? Because now we can talk very big within pharma industry, but once upon a time we were also students. So we need to give opportunity to students also to work, to do internship, or technical induction part must be also very strong in industry. And whenever they will be inducted in industry, so slowly we need to really align these freshers or students or researchers so that they will be aligned with the industry culture for the benefit of the mankind, to make the very, very impactful medicines, because it is a novel profession, right? So I think this will take time. Some countries in this world, they must be very, very advanced. Some are not. But if we really consciously put our effort, slowly this change will be happening. This is already started happening in India. I must tell that, okay, various organizations are in India are really working into that direction. But maybe the output from the academic institutes, the number of students are very, very high with compared to the input of the industry. So we need to think and we need to work together how we can solve these problems. But overall, the concepts I want to really clear, whatever I have thought with you, I will be expecting your opinion in the chat box. Maybe after some time we can discuss on that. And why the freshers are very, very important, because if we can align them in a proper way, they are very, very energetic. They are green, they are energetic, they are bubbling with creativity. And who knows that they can only give birth of few medicines and few novel molecules, and which can really cure cancer, or which can cure lot of incurable diseases in the world. Because in my life, I have seen the cancer patients when I was working with anti-cancer molecule clinical trial. I have seen those patients. Their life is very, very painful. Patients are needing right medicines. Who will be making those medicines? If we can really care for the newcomers, freshers, and really care for them, so definitely their creativity will give a lot of medicines in the world. That's why I put a quotation from ancient literature of India. Mrittoma amrito gamayo, tamoshoma jyotir kamayo, ashotoma ashat kamayo. It means actually mrittoma amrito gamayo. Let the science and all almighty takes us from death to a state where no death will be there in this earth at all. It's amrit, okay? In that path we must travel. And pharmacy profession, we are all pharmacists because we are contributing for the benefit of the mankind, and we are all serving life. Finally, we want to see the smiles in this picture. You are seeing all the smiles in different people's face. We want to see the smiles within people. We are all working together into that direction. And thank you so much. I think in that way, I am stopping sharing my slide. And I will be expecting if any questions or any thoughts from your side. Thank you so much.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Beda, for this wonderful talk. It's a great experience. And, you know, I can fully understand where you are coming from, you know, and the skill will part. And I think for all the viewers who are there, you know, you can see people, you know, coming, joining. So it's a movement around our platform. So I hope that all these 100 plus registered people will get, you know, enough exposure. And we will be also streaming your presentation on our, you know, YouTube platform. So coming back to your presentation, you know, during your, you know, long career, you know, you must have hired many people. So what was your, you know, let's say tendency, you know, how can you really figure out in the short, because interview period is only 30 minutes, you know, 45 or max one and a half hours. How can you really hire for the attitude and then train for the skills, you know? So this is the question to you in this
wonderful
short span.
Okay. Yeah. Yes, sure. So you are really asking me not the technical part, how I can judge the attitude of the people, right? So here, reference play a very, very vital role, okay? In the CV, okay. I have told that CV has to be made in a very, very right way. So reference plays a very vital role, okay? I don't hesitate to talk with the reference so that I can get some idea. And few questions, really, whenever I will be talking with them, the way they are standing, the way they are talking, and the way they are answering the question, the clarity of thought they are having, and their career ambitions. If I am asking the questions, why you have come to pharma industry? One simple question, really, I can judge them how much original they are in their thinking. Why they want to come in pharma industry? What is the connection? How much they are inspired internally? They want to make a new medicines. Okay, so three, four questions really, Kuntal, I can really judge the people. What is their inner connection with that? If the inner connection is very, very strong, I can be assured that they will be serving the industry and for the purpose very, very effectively.
Wonderful. Thank you. So, you know, yeah. I think you told all of us that you will hire for the attitude. So you will hire the people based on the attitude and based on the reference. And then if required, you will train them for the skills, you know, so then the attitude and skills, you know, match. So will and skill, what you are telling. Wonderful. So my second question, which of course come from one of the audience, basically, how do you see, you know, we are all living, unfortunately, in this digital world, you know, we would love to go and interact, but due to this COVID, which is never ending, you know, we were in our homes measuring this digital platform. So can you tell us about your, you know, consultancy company and how, you know, you have plans, because we are grateful to have been connected with you. For RxCella, how you can bring this, you know, people from academics to the industry and vice versa, you know, maybe some few lines from your side.
Sure. So now at this moment of time, at least in India, things are opened up. Physical interaction already started. Okay, with wonderful. My platform, whatever I have designed, really, it is a 3 days workshop. 2 days will be completely technical, the bigger picture and specific picture. And in physical setup, I am thinking a lot of videos will be there, and definitely we can give a very good understanding about pharma industry, from patent management to R&D to production to quality control to quality assurance, clinical trial, regulatory affairs, animal toxicity study, how it is reaching to patient. This bigger picture is very, very important. Through that bigger picture, a new candidate can also identify, I can also apply in patent management. I can also work in being an engineer. Also, I can contribute in pharma industry. So bigger picture is very, very important. And I'm trying to develop some virtual reality module so that nowadays, probably if it is not possible to go to industry through that virtual reality platform, people can get enough exposure to really visualize the industry virtually. But I feel, because sometimes if I do hands-on also in academics or in a small setup, whenever we'll be going to industry, it will be a completely different set of equipments, no match altogether. So what is important, that giving them an environment, virtual environment, is also perfectly fine, so that they are having an understanding, how it works in industry, but getting those 200 concepts. So online also, I did a pilot with one institute in Kolkata, which is called ISAR. It is a very, very famous institute, ISAR. I did a pilot of this program virtually. And nowadays, I will start very soon doing it workshop wise, so that I will be going to institute. If institute is inviting me, I will be going there. It can be abroad also, within India also. I am having tie up. I am trying to coordinate with different educational institutes. They are also showing a lot of interest on my project, so that I can, before pharma industry goes for the campus recruitment, so they know definitely at one level how really it works in industry. And definitely, I am positive with this basic knowledge. 2 days will be technical, 1 day will be behavioral part. So that's will part also I am taking care of. So skill and will, I will try. But what I will be needing, only the serious students I will be needing, okay? Because I will be putting effort. I want also students and researchers to put their effort. It must be in the right mindset, okay? So I will be requesting serious students to join my workshop. And any academic institute can invite me. I can arrange to go there, and we can work together for the betterment of this world. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you, brother. So Mario, Moa, any questions from your side? I can see Mario has written, you know, that it has been a wonderful, you know, motivated experience from an entrepreneur, you know, like you, and for the right opportunities, you know, to give freshers a chance. I can see another question from Moa coming in, that what is the goal of RXLA? I think you have told that briefly. What is the plan for the freshers? Can you please let us know in few words, like freshers, you know, should they register in your platform? So can you tell us in few words, what should the freshers do to get in contact with you?
Definitely. I have given my email ID in the chat box. I can again type maybe 1 minute, and my LinkedIn profile is there. I am checking my email ID, and you can also coordinate with the organizers. So it will be better if, but not personally, you, your institute coordinates with me. If I am getting minimum 20 people and maximum 30 people, I will be ready to conduct the workshop, 3 days workshop for the people from various background. I have developed program for core pharmacy students. I have developed program for life science students. I have developed for engineer, because their background is something different. Okay, I developed various kinds of programs all 3 days. So it will be nice if institute really coordinates with me with minimum 20 strengths. So definitely we can work together, fix 3 dates. Okay. And physical workshop will be preferable. If it is not happening, virtual also I can connect. Maybe it will prolong a little bit more, because virtually it is not possible to engage for 6 to 7 hours daily. It will be too much tedious for us, and learning will not be apt. Okay. So learning, we must be, our mind must be relaxed, and we should not burden our brain too much. So all the learning philosophy also I imported in this program, because I worked in learning and development last 2-3 years. All the science and philosophy, I tried my best to ensure that learning is entertaining, fun, and engaging. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Veda, for all your, you know, chat. It's really a wonderful experience. Again, we will definitely spread the word across, and yes, we would like to welcome you in all our future, you know, Pharmacircuit conferences. And thanks for the opportunity. Thanks for being there.
And that, Mario, one word also I must share with you. We have also talked, I think, 2 months back, that if online permanent kind of setup, if we can put, that is also
absolutely our, that is on our
Yes, it is in our agenda also. Okay. I, Mario, you, and Mohua talk together. So all the modules, if it can be sit at one place,
It
will be, so it will not be Beda dependent, but it will be really system dependent. So that will be definitely.
Sure. So you know, Mario presented in the first presentation already about this franchise, but very good. You know, we are also planning. So thank you again for reinforcing that. We will definitely keep this in mind, and we will, you know, work together. So with that, I would like to then formally end this session. We will be back with our next session in next 2-3 minutes. So thank you, Bedada, for being there. Have a nice day, and we look forward to having you again.
Thank you so much, Kuntal, Maria, Mohua, and all the audience and students joining this session. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks. Bye-bye.